Hey, this is Bill Renz with Wise Nurseries Garden Center. I want to talk to you briefly about pH levels in the soil and what that means to you and your landscape. Now listen and listen very closely because this is a very common problem that is often overlooked and not addressed properly that makes a big, big difference when it comes to you, your yard, and your investment in your landscape and being successful and making sure that your yard performs like you expect it to. But basically, when I talk about pH levels in the soil, or when you hear people in agriculture in general refer to pH levels, they're actually talking about how alkaline or how acidic the actual soil is, okay? Now, most plants want to be between a 6 and a 7. You don't necessarily have to split hairs about this. You just want to be in that comfortable realm, all right? Now, there are some plants that like a little bit more on the acidic side, particularly like azaleas, camellias, sasanqua, ferns, agapanthus, and several others. But on the grand scheme, most plants you want to be between a 6 and a 7. This is very important because if the pH is not within that comfortable spectrum or realm, the nutrients will actually be locked up and not available to absorb properly to the plant. So what ends up happening is you invest in your new landscape, but yet the pH level is off, you install the material properly, you fertilize it properly, you water it properly, and 2-3 years down the road, the material's looking anemic and you can't figure out why. And that's why it's so important to go ahead and check your pH level off the bat while you're making the initial install so you know, because it's not that big a deal to correct. It's really easily done. We carry these over-the-counter pH testers. One of these testers actually will do the pH level 4 times, along with nitrogen, phosphate, and potassium as well. But I don't want you to feel overwhelmed at testing all that. The main thing that I want you to focus on is getting your pH level right. Because if you get your pH level right, and then you use a good, just broad-spectrum fertilizer that has all your major and minor elements in it, a lot of times those other categories will fall into place. Okay? Now, what do you do if your pH level's off? Let's say that you test the soil and it turns out to be a 7.3, which is kind of uncommon for this part of Georgia. Usually you're a little on the acidic, but I have seen it happen, and you can actually use aluminum sulfate in the landscape. But like I said, that this is not nearly as common, but this will actually bring the pH level down, okay? Or if you've got some hydrangeas that you want to turn blue by dropping the pH level, use aluminum sulfate. Or a few azaleas or camellias in the landscape, but the rest of the landscape you want to leave a little bit on the higher side, just use aluminum sulfate on just those plants. But more times, or more often, you're going to actually need to raise the pH level. It's very common here in this part of Georgia, or the whole state actually of Georgia, for it to be a little on the low side, and you need to raise up, make it a little bit more alkaline, because like I said, if that soil's too acidic, it's going to lock that nutrients up. You can properly plant it, properly feed it, and properly water it, and the plants over a long-term period is still going to end up looking anemic and not grow real vigorously and not grow healthy, and that's just going to turn into disappointment in the performance of the actual landscape and also set those plants up for pest and disease issues, okay, because they're actually not healthy and their immune system would be wore down. But one way you can correct by bringing the pH level back up is by using lime, all right? Now, this is a product made by Espoma. It's called Lightning Lime. It's really cool. It actually is 5 times stronger than regular lime, and it reacts in only 6 to 8 weeks. So you can fix a problem very quickly with Lightning Lime. We also carry more traditional lime that actually takes about 6 months to react. So if you go with the more traditional lime, you're looking at more a long-term strategy where if you figure out you have a severe problem and you want to correct it quickly, you also have options like Lightning Lime. But like I said, this is very, very important. Too often, I get phone calls or get photographs or job sites that the plants just are not performing. Everything's done right, seems like, in 2, 3, 4 years down the road, stuff's just not performing properly and looking good and not really looking very healthy, and it just turned out to be the pH level. Very simple, cheap fix, okay? So don't let too many years go by, or don't let that be you where you find out you have that problem in your yard 3 years from now. Check the pH level. Come get one of these little test kits, all right? It is worth the investment, all right? Y'all come down to Wise Nurseries Garden Center. We'll lead you in the right direction. We'll see you around.